his name, bignaw his deeds among the people. Sing unto him, sing songs unto him. Talk ye of all his wondrous works. Glory be in his name. Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his face forevermore. Remember his marvelous works that he has done, his wonders and the judgments of his mouth. I just read to you Psalms 105, 1 through the 5th verse. Let me bow our hands and pray. Oh God, we come in the name of Jesus this evening, asking that you will bless this program. We also ask that you will look upon Grambling State University Choir. Bless them. Give them traveling grace as they travel throughout the rest of the year, Lord. We also ask that you will also look upon our university. Bless our president, faculty, and staff. And then, Lord, we ask that you will look upon Marcus Rose, who directs this choir. Continue to give him the wisdom and the knowledge from above. We thank you also for this church that has allowed us to come in and to have this fellowship. Bless this church. Bless this community, bless this state and this nation. We ask that what we do will be pleasing in your sight. In Jesus' name we pray, let us all respond by saying amen.
Amen.
We of Ebony Hugh have always had a song to sing. Whether it was a song of message from the plantation fields, spiritual songs of faith in our little churches, songs of love and faith and pain through our contemporary ballads, songs of politics through reggae, songs of modern anguish, dissatisfaction, and disassociation through rap, and songs of Grambling through the writing and directing of our choral masters. We have given our best voice to music. Beginning with Mignon Cabell, on to Mildred Shawande, through Mark Francis and L.L. Luss, the standards of choral music were set. When Robert E. Bob Williams came on the scene, the opportunities were broadened and strengthened. Grambling College, Grambling State University's program blossomed. For some of us, it was a mandate to become involved in a choir after high school. For others, it was an educational requirement as music majors. And yet still for others, it was just for the love of singing that we became members of the Grambling College, Grambling State University Choir. It did not matter if you came from a small community or a large metropolitan city. If you made the choir, you were somebody. We all had a chance to be mentored and directed by a man with an untiring spirit and unlimited resources. Non-monetary, of course. From being on tour and living in a haunted mansion in Kansas City in the dead of winter, to recording in a huge, beautiful church in Louisville because the acoustics were great and the pastor was a friend. From singing in St. Louis churches to being a part of the USO tour, in addition to singing with the City Symphony Orchestra, music became the part of our friendships we established and the fabric of our lives. The modern day choral music masters have taken that foundation and moved forward. McCoy Ransom, Terry Alexander, Cheryl Clancy, John Ethel Page Minnifield, Larry Rhodes, Patricia Britton, and the current master, Marcus J. Rhodes, have greatly added to the choral program at Grambling. Traveling some of the same roads previously traveled by pioneers, in addition to breaking new ground and branching out to the global community, it is a fulfillment of a dream. The current musicians are examples of a markedly enhanced music program. Tonight, we are to listen to voices ringing forth with enthusiasm, expertise, experience, and love. In recognition of the past, respect for, and blessings of the present, and visionary preparation for the future. The voices of angels still abound.
Captain, did you hear about? Lord, I will move.
Captain, did you hear about?
Lord, Okay, well, we can't get them, but for the ones that's here, Marcus, we would like to just extend our appreciation to you, all of the wonderful things that you've done with the University Choir, and to show our appreciation, we, the alumni, have a token to present to you.
Thank you everybody for coming out this evening.